Guys, after we set all the decking, now is the time to jump on top of it to start marking all the slab edges, balconies, fire collars, check the connection with the core and make sure all information is passed to the workforce. So let's go! So guys, first of all, at this point, we need all the information now into our controller, into our total station. If you use a robotic, that's gonna be obviously the CAD or DXF drawing now into robotic, so we can tap the lines, we can set everything, stake out from it, use everything we want. And how to take that information in your EDM, you can check on one of my video when I'm showing you how to do it, how to take the drawings into EDM. So you're gonna be able to set out from it. And the most important thing, guys, at this point, all information we need to be clarified, all information needs to be confirmed. And let's have a look at the drawing, guys. Position of all these fire collars now have to be clarified. You can have a look actually on one of my videos when I was RFIing this. You can have a look where to ask the question, but at this point all this have to be clarified. Your senior engineer should provide you with this information before, and it's really a little bit too late to ask this question, so make sure you got all this before we actually be jumping on top. And if you're using a TS-06, guys, I really recommend you to use a local grid, to create a local grid. You can have a look as well on one of my video when I'm showing you how to do it. And you should at this point as well, you have the all points now into your instrument, so either you type them in or you copy them in using the USB, but you want this ready by now. So having your information in the EDM is a one thing, but I want you at this point, guys, to have a folder with all the drawings here. Let's have a look at what I got here. I got the sections here and the details. Obviously, as I told you last time, the GA drawing gonna be our starter for it, so we got all the information, what drawing number, what section number we're gonna be using, we're gonna be looking for, and then we're gonna be taking our information. So EDM with all setting out the information inside, and the folder with all the drawings, so you can have a look at the drawing and just to make sure you're doing the right thing. So guys, now is the time to actually take our EDM on top and set it. But before we do it, guys, I want you to actually, on the way to do that, I want you to check all these connections here with the core, make sure all quick cast strips are in, and if anything is missing here, guys, now is the time to flag it up and make sure everything gonna be rectified. We are working as a team, guys, we helping each other, but you cannot have 100% trust in your slip form engineer, and especially everyone makes a mistake. So that's our role, guys, now to pick up this stuff. So if there are any conning bars missing, guys, we want to make sure we're gonna drill it properly. And for instance, in position like here, there might be some couplers needed, so we want to make sure they're not missing here, maybe here as well. There might be bigger bars, so if they're going to be 20-25 mil bar, guys, that's going to be a problem now. Each time you're going to be, guys, going for your break, for your when you're going to be coming back, just have a quick look. The concrete guy is going to be actually first to be there. They're going to be opening the quickest strip and preparing everything for the fixers to jump in. So guys, now is the time to actually set our EDM there on top. And how are we going to do it? So we're going to use a column for it, and I'm going to tell you a little bit more about it in the last video when I'm going to be talking more about the columns. But in the columns on top, we should install the pipe, which later we're going to use to insert our monopod there. And Chip is probably going to install them as well for the hangman when they're going to be doing the decking, but we want to make sure they're actually going to use it. There is a company called Servipod, and I'm going to leave the link below so you can have a look at the product. So even if you miss that pipe there, they got a bolt fix solution for it, so you can still set your EDM on it. So that's great, it's a good idea. But obviously, guys, at this point we need all this stuff on site already, we cannot just order it now, so we need to think about it before, how we're going to set up and where we're going to set up and what targets we're going to use. So we assuming now we got the targets all around, and let's go back to that drawing there. Let's assume we're going to be using actually this column just to set our EDM. So from here we're going to do all our setting out. So guys, once our EDM is set there on top, we want to make sure our error is minimal as always, and now we're going to be starting setting out. I want you to start off what I'm going to call the soffit items. So let's have a look here. On some sides, you're gonna actually find the halfens running on the soffit. So I would actually start from here. If you got any items like that running through the soffit, that would be first to go, guys. When the fixer is gonna go and start installing the bottom mesh, that's gonna be a big problem later, as they're gonna be blaming us for it. Sometimes on some sides, there's a plates there as well. Look at this photo, guys. It's crazy. Look at the number of the plates here. It's crazy. You can have a look at that. There's actually the servit monopod as well they're using there. So look how crazy it is, guys. That's the first things to go. Always the soffit items, obviously. I intentionally picked up the different drawing to the last one here. So you got the downstand beam here, guys, 755 deep. And if your columns are actually spot on, you can actually measure off the columns, so the chippies can use the columns. But I will definitely check it later when we set up the EDM. Look at this balcony here. That's the lower level balcony. But at this point, guys, that area should be already lower now, and the decking should be ready there with that 150 step. And if you're looking on the other side here, we got a balcony there with a TB, which is a thermal brake. So that will be our start, guys, there as well, to mark these balconies so the guys can start installing the thermal brake. And then if you can have a look here as well, that's the downstand beam here. So that's gonna be same story as on the other side. And we got a sections here. So we got section number 35 from drawing number 108. and I'm going to show you that in a minute. So at this point, guys, obviously we're going to be marking all the boxes, all the penetrations, all the services here. Now there's all items going into Sofit, so we want to install them actually before the fixer is going to jump there. And if you come back here next to the core, obviously we're checking the core all the time, but we got a balcony stops here as well. That's a section 18 on drawing number 108. I'm going to show you that in a minute. That'll be another one to mark now. They might be actually coming after the bottom mesh, but you want to mark it now. You want to make sure your lines are running here, so they're not going to be any confusion later when they're going to start installing the stabs. So I'm going to go now to have a look at the sections. So we got section 16 here, we got section 35. So you can see that dashed line around the building. That typically means there's going to be some half ends coming into the slab edge, but I'm going to say a little bit more about this in the next video when I'm going to be doing actually the checks, the pre-pull check, and we're going to be checking when the chip is going to be actually installing the slab edge here. We're going to have a look if they installed all the half ends there. So I'm going to go now to the sections. I'm going to start from number 11 here, which is the balcony now with a step in the soffit. I'm going to show you the number 12 as well, which is the balcony now with the thermal break with no step there. That's the two sections here, as you can see. That's number 11 here, so that's the step in the soffit, and that's the step on top here with a small 50 millimeters upstand there. So that's why I want you to have all these drawings with you, so we can have a look. You're going to see how it meant to look. And we got a section 12 through the other balcony here. You can see the clearly marked, it should be 80 mil thermal break. There will be another drawing actually issued from these guys here when they're going to show you which item to use in the particular balcony and all the calculations there as well. So we actually want to use that one. But as I said, I'm going to cover that in the next video when we're going to be actually checking if all the items are in and everything is in position. So I'm going to go back to that GA. We're going to have a look how that downstand beam looks here. And we're going to have a look what that dashed line actually looks. So that's going to be section 35 on drawing 108. I got the drawing 108 here, and the section 35 is this one here. So that's our downstand beam here, guys. And you can see here, that's our half end. They call it half end, but it's an icon channel. So 3020, you got a type of the channel here, continues all the way through that step. And this is going to be installed there on that shutter when the chip is going to be closing. So as I said, in the next video, we're going to have a closer look at it. Obviously, guys, we want to confirm the height of it. We want to make sure everything is installed as it should be. But that's going to be here on the architect's drawing, elevation drawing. So guys, I think that will be all in terms of marking the slab here. The very first thing we're going to be doing, the checking the core, marking all the soffit items, the castings. And what I also recommend you guys, once your EDM is there, you can just spot check your slab level. So that's the soffit you got there. So you want to just spot check. You want to make sure the level is good. So that will be like a double check in your level. And at this point, guys, while we're doing all this, just don't forget to keep checking, look at the drawings, provide the information to the guys, as this is our role to little babysit there as well. So guys, I think that will be all in today's video. We got all the information now with it in the EDM. We know how to set it now on top, on the decking. We know what to start with, what we're going to start marking, and what we need to have a look as well. We got all drawings with all sections, all details. So all the time we can refer to them and make sure we do the right thing all the time. And in the next video, guys, we're going to have a look on all the slabage. We want to make sure all the castings, all the slabage items are installed there. And we're going to have a look at the rebar drawing as well. We're going to do all the pre-pour and make sure everything is ready to be poured. So guys, thank you again for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, turn the bell notification on, and leave the thumbs up. So see you next time.